Meet Cliff. Cliff is into bungee jumping. He just realized that his beloved hobby is considered a hazardous activity. This is going to affect Cliff's ability to purchase life insurance. Stick around till the end of this video if you too are involved in hazardous activities but would also like to purchase life insurance. First things first. What is considered a hazardous activity? Hazardous activities are high-risk hobbies include bungee jumping, race car driving, horseback riding, and the list goes on. Hazardous activities are not exclusively hobbies. Some jobs such as construction workers or underground mining are considered high-risk activities as well. While I have your attention, please hit that subscribe button and bell button to join our notification squad. These activities are not covered by life insurance since the potential for injury or life loss is rather higher than the normal activities. The alternative is to pay higher premiums to offset the higher risk associated with these activities. Some insurance companies would issue policies that would exclude hazardous activities from coverage. This means that if something goes wrong and is related to the hazardous activity, it will not be covered by the life insurance. Other unrelated activities will be dealt with separately and will be covered. We know what some of you may be thinking. You don't need to mention this in the life insurance application. You think it would make your life easier. Wrong. Omitting this information from the application is considered fraud. During the application, the insurance company would use this information in generating the amount of premiums you pay. Check out our other video on how insurance companies calculate premiums. The insurance company would have the right to cancel the insurance policy. Even worse, the insurance company may demand payment of adjusted premiums. The insurance company can also reduce the death benefit provided to the beneficiaries. To be on the same page, hazardous activities are not standard in all insurance companies. You should ask the company you are interested in buying insurance from what they consider as a high-risk activity. Another thing is that occasional high-risk activities such as scuba diving will not change your classification into a high-risk applicant. So, an infrequent activity within a vacation will be just fine. If you like this video, make sure you demolish that subscribe button and join our notification squad by hitting that bell button.